You have a gift. Tonight is about us, about our strength, our love. Let's go get this win for each other.
We're on the road to Super Bowl 53.
But nobody said that road was easy. An expectation.
A belief that someone will.
Or should achieve something.
Come November,
your expectations bring the season to a crossroads.
You'll ask, is age more than just a number?
Are my glory days behind me?
It can even make a Super Bowl champion have to.
Look in the mirror.
Are you ready to get inside the mind?
Because you know.
Nobody
knows the game like a quarterback.
They're going to have 35 points 2 weeks in a row in the first half.
31 touchdowns, a Kansas City Chiefs record.
A furious comeback is going to come up short.
The Cowboys have played their best game of the year when you least thought they had it in them.
Buckle up.
NFL Monday QB.
Monday QB.
Monday QB is now.
Welcome to another edition of NFL Monday QB, delivered to you by FedEx. I'm Adam Schein. You know my quarterbacks, Rich Gannon, Steve Berline, my guy Trent Green. Former Assistant is going to join us coming up in a bit, but for right now, we dive right into an NFL Sunday that either helped or hurt several teams' playoff lives, and we'll do it in just a few words.
Several words could describe an absolutely crucial 10th Sunday in this NFL season. Vrabel gets Titanic win, Rams roll over Russell, or even Trubisky bears down on the Lions. Yes, those are all extremely crucial, extremely playoff implicating type words, but nothing could be more crucial, more playoff implicating than these words. NFC East desperation, Dak versus Carson, the boys versus the birds. Whatever you want to call this NFC East rivalry, these two familiar foes had one thing on their minds Sunday night, and that was to win. Sunday night's game in Philly was as close to a must-win as it gets in November. And for the Cowboys, Thanksgiving came early. Dak and the Cowboys should be extremely thankful to grab the win and grab some playoff life.
And Elliott works his way through and walks the dog.
Dak and Zeke showed up when it mattered most, and America's team showed no love to the Eagles in the city that is known for the brotherly kind. Speaking of love, you're gonna love these words. The Saints march on. Drew breezes past Brett. New Orleans faced Cincinnati on Sunday, and on paper, this matchup looked like a good one. Too bad for the Bengals, that was only on paper. The Saints marched into Ohio with swagger and marched out of Ohio with swagger.
Brees from the empty backfield drops back, looks in the slot. Mike Thomas across the end zone. Touchdown, Saints!
Dalton and company couldn't climb out of a major hole, and the only one who did any climbing was Drew Brees. Drew passed by Brett and now sits in the second spot on one of the most coveted lists the NFL has to offer. Words like those aren't said too often.
Yes, words that are not heard very often indeed. Drew Brees is on a different level this season as he climbs another spot on one of the most prestigious lists in all of sports. Rich, how about it? Another week, another major accomplishment for Drew Brees.
Yeah, pretty amazing, Adam. And honestly, that wasn't a fair fight yesterday in Cincinnati. I mean, you have the best offense in football against the worst defense in football. They just destroyed them. You know, the Saints have scored 40 or more points in more than half their games this season. And Drew Brees is really having an MVP-type season. He's completing 77% of his passes. He's thrown 21 touchdowns in just a single pick. I think when you look at Ingram and Kamara and how they're playing right now, it's incredible. And certainly congratulations from all the quarterbacks here at the NFL Monday QB to a guy that certainly deserves it. Think about what he's accomplished in his career, second all-time in passing touchdowns. Congratulations, Drew.
Yes, Rich. The numbers kind of speak for themselves, what he's done this year and over the course of the career, the consistency, the durability. We talk about it, it seems like, every week, and you kind of run out of things to say. But the bottom line is, it's that just is a testament to his greatness. I think one of the most impressive things about this year, what he's doing, though, is this football team is 5-0 on the road. Think about that. Now, we always used to look at the New Orleans Saints as a team that was great at home, you know, kind of 50-50 on the road. This year, 5-0 on the road. That tells me they can go deep in December.
Drew Brees was unstoppable on Sunday against the Bengals, but listen, Trent, let's be honest here. A lot of quarterbacks have looked unstoppable against a Bengals defense who just fired their defensive coordinator, Terrell Austin, on Monday morning.
Well, really, the Bengals had no choice but to fire Austin. When you consider going into the bye week against Tampa Bay, the win they got against Tampa Bay, they gave up 450 yards passing. So during the bye week, what are we going to do to figure out how to stop Drew Brees? The good news for the Bengals, Drew Brees was held to 265 yards passing. The problem is they gave up 244 yards rushing. So when you consider the last three games, they've given up over 500 yards of total offense. You look at them, they're on a historic pace in terms of yards given up. At the rate they're going, they're going to finish as the worst defense in NFL history. So really there was no choice that Marvin Lewis had but to fire Austin. And here's the crazy thing about it, Adam. If the season ended today, the Bengals are still in the playoffs. They're the sixth seed. They're the last wild card team to get in. So even though they were 4-1 a few weeks ago, at the rate they're going right now, they're losing, but they're still in the playoffs. So they get some healthy bodies back on defense. So hopefully they get things turned around defensively.
You know, it's crazy when you say that they'd be in if the playoffs started today. They don't. In the NFC, if the playoffs started today, the Philadelphia Eagles would not make it, Trent. Are the champs, after losing last night, are they done?
You know, mathematically, they're not done, but realistically, yes, they are done. When you consider they have seven games left, they're sitting at 4-5, they're only a game out of the playoffs, but they're the 11th seed because of tiebreakers. They're only 2-4 in conference. But they look at their remaining seven games. They have four games against their division, and then the three games they have outside of their division are against the Rams, the Saints, and the Texans, three of the hottest teams in the NFL. So what they're going to have to do mathematically is they're going to have to sweep the four remaining games in their division and then hope to get a win out of those three hot teams, which I don't think is going to happen. So, Steve, I don't think how they're going to move forward when you look at them in the playoff picture.
Trent, you know, I'm going to take the opposite side of that argument. I think the fact that six of their last seven games in the NFC really works for them, especially when you consider that four of those games are divisional games, with two of them against the Redskins, so they can make up ground in a hurry in that NFC East. But the real big problem for the Eagles, I think, to this point has been the injuries at both running back and defensive back. I think they've got the people to pick it up and step in and play well. Just got to feed the ball a little bit more to Josh Adams, get that running game going to take some of the pressure off of Carson Wentz.
You know, Rich, Dak Prescott has had a very uneven season. I think that's a fair way to phrase it. I thought he was superb in the second half in that victory last night. How did he turn things around in such a big spot when it mattered the most?
Well, I think he got some help. And, you know, I think it was kind of, it's been an uneven type of season for the Cowboys. They're 4-5. I think it was a gritty performance last night from Dak Prescott. You know, when he's playing well and they're able to run the football with Ezekiel Elliott and also complement that with some pass plays out of the backfield and the play of their defense, to me, I mean, that's how they got it done last night. It was kind of a complimentary performance. But look, I tip my hat to Dak Prescott. He rushed for a touchdown last night. He threw for a touchdown. He made some good decisions. He made some big plays outside the pocket. And this is really how the Cowboys are going to have to remain competitive the rest of the way, by playing better defensively, by pounding the football, and getting some productive performances from Dak Prescott.
Absolutely. And Rich, Dak Prescott and the Cowboys needed to win in the worst possible way. And as we know, former Cowboy and recently signed Saint Dez Bryant is out for the season before his even began. Now, there's a new veteran wide receiver in New Orleans, and for the latest on everything going on in the league, let's welcome in our NFL and CBS insider, Jason Lockenfora. JLC, what do we got?
Well, Adam, Brandon Marshall lost out on that tryout to Dez Bryant a week ago in New Orleans, but now he's in line to actually play for the Saints. They signed him on Monday. Expect him to be active soon enough, and maybe he gets to the playoffs for the first time in his career. Unfortunately for the Rams, Cooper Kupp will not be a part of their playoff push. Kupp indeed suffered an ACL tear in that game on Sunday. He's out for the year. They hope he's back for the start of next season. With the New York Jets, well, I don't believe Todd Bowles will be back there by the start of the season. He is not, however, I'm told, in danger of being fired imminently. Ownership has discussed where they're going. They don't want to make a move right now. Traditionally, the Jets have not fired coaches in season, but I would be stunned if Todd Bowles is actually back there next year. As for the Baltimore Ravens, Coach John Harbaugh said today he doesn't know who his starting quarterback will be on Sunday. Joe Flacco dealing with a hip injury. I continue to hear Lamar Jackson very likely to make his first NFL start against the Bengals. And Ryan Fitzpatrick remains Tampa's starter for now, although Jameis Winston in play in the coming weeks.
A lot going on, Jason. We appreciate it. Now, in spite of Cooper Kupp's injury, Jared Goff and the Rams still got back to their winning ways on Sunday. But it's Drew Brees and the Saints who look like the team to beat in the NFC.
Describe this offense right now.
Savage.
Savage. Some dog.
Two American icons are joining forces for a collaboration a century in the making. Budweiser and Jim Beam introduce the Budweiser Reserve Copper Lager, a rich lager aged on Jim Beam bourbon barrel staves with hints of vanilla and caramel rye, followed by a deliciously smooth finish.
There are those who choose a different path in life. The path of selflessness. Of service. The path that leads to freedom. Do you have what it takes? Find out at GoArmy.com/warriors.
4WP is more than a store. We're truck and Jeep experts. From wheel and tire upgrades to full custom builds, 4WP has you covered. Do your rig right. Shop online or find your store at 4WP.com.
The zip, the clip, the clean sweep, the nose nip, neck notch, tweet, touch up, and total takedown. For any man, every man, Con Air Man.
It's not what champions do. It's what champions don't do. They don't back down, they don't settle, and they don't quit. Except for Cable.
Cable?
Yeah, you quit Cable. Because we are Cougars, and we don't quit. Unless what?
Unless it's Cable!
Quit Cable and switch to DirecTV and get the most live sports in 4K. More for your thing, that's our thing. 1-800-DIRECTV.
Start your morning right with a healthy serving of sports. A dash of salt.
Shut up. I don't really care what you're doing. All I care about is what I'm doing.
A hint of spice.
But I really do believe that they could win this whole thing.
Then let it cook for 4 hours. Boomer and Geo. Weekday mornings starting at 6 on CBS Sports Network.
NFL Monday QB on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by FedEx. Possibilities. What we deliver by delivering.
You never really feel comfortable when he's out there and with the ball and has a chance to win.
Russell Wilson hump fakes. He throws. No good. It's incomplete left side.
It was tough today. It was a very tough win and one that we grinded out and lucky to come away with.
He got open on the outside and it was just me doing my job, sitting back there and getting the ball to the playmakers.
Nice clean pocket. Going deep for Allen Robinson. Over the shoulder. Making it a catch. Touchdown Bears.
I don't think we mind being that role, being in that role. You know, underdog, people count us out and fine with us.
Rookie end zone fires, caught, Redskins touchdown.
But certainly I'd like to say that we're a tough-minded, gritty team.
Here's a look at the NFC playoff picture as the Rams, Saints, Bears, Redskins all lead their divisions and are looking strong after each team enjoyed big wins in week number 10. Speaking of looking strong, Let's welcome back in Boomer Esiason, NFL Monday QB.
Thanks for having me back. Hey, it's great to be here. Always talking about quarterbacks and who's playing well and who's not playing well.
So with that said, Boom, who's the best team in the NFC?
You know, I think it's the Saints. They were my preseason pick to make it to the Super Bowl with the New England Patriots. They've done nothing to diminish in my eyes who I thought they were going to be. And Drew Brees is having another magical year. He's got two tremendous running backs. Their offensive line just absolutely hammered the LA Rams 2 weeks ago. This game yesterday against the Bengals is more like a 7-on-7 scrimmage. The Bengals defense has been so bad as of late, but they are flying and they are rocking and rolling. They're going to be pretty difficult to beat at home.
Absolutely. And the Rams just lost to the Saints a week ago, bounced back against the Seahawks on Sunday. And Todd Gurley was incredible. Aaron Donald, he's the defensive player of the year. Jared Goff has been outstanding. Rich, Jared Goff has been great. But can anyone play quarterback for Sean McVay's team with the plethora of weapons? How much credit here do you think Jared Goff deserves?
Adam, I think there's plenty of credit to go around. Certainly, Jared Goff deserves a lot of it. They're 9-1. He's playing some of his best football. I think he gets better each and every time out. Remember how this guy started. He was 0-7 in his first year under Jeff Fisher. But he's got good talent around him. There's no question about it. You know, he's putting up big numbers every week. I look at his career numbers. It's impressive. And even this season, he's completing 68%. He's thrown 22 touchdowns. And what I like best, and you guys know me, I look at this number. He's thrown just 6 picks. He's taken care of the football, and he's putting his team in a position to have a chance to win each week.
Well, you know, I agree with everything you said, Rich. Great points. But I think any quarterback in their right mind would love the opportunity to play quarterback in this system under Sean McVay with those weapons around him. I mean, we would all kill for that opportunity. Now, a lot of quarterbacks who we would consider to be average quarterbacks would be very productive in that system with those weapons. But only a few quarterbacks will be able to get the most out of that, be able to make that Super Bowl run. So it takes a great quarterback or great quarterback play to make that Super Bowl run. So to answer the question, a lot of players would love to play in that opportunity, but only a few will be able to get it done and take it all the way to the finish line.
You know, I'm going to state some obvious things. First off, Todd Gurley is the number one rusher in the NFL. You got Cooks and Woods at wide receiver. They're two of the top 10 wide receivers in the NFL. The Rams are number 3 in the NFL in yards after catch. So, yes, they have all the weapons around them, but it's the play of Jared Goff, the fact that he is making deliveries, getting accurate throws. As Rich said, he's not turning the football over. I tell my kids all the time, if it was easy, everybody would do it. Playing quarterback in the NFL is not easy, and Jared Goff is playing at an extremely high level. So to answer your question, I don't know if anybody can just step in there and play, Adam, but Jared Goff is playing at a very high level and is pushing this team forward in the right direction.
Absolutely, and he deserves a ton of credit for it. McVay, offensive genius, a lot of weapons, as the guys mentioned. Goff has been outstanding. Goff is obviously leading a division. Yep. So is Mitchell Trubisky. So is Alex Smith. Boomer, choose one. Trubisky or Alex Smith?
I'm going to take Mitchell Trubisky, and here's why. I don't want to play it safe. If you want to win the Super Bowl in the NFC, you can't play it safe. Alex Smith is a safe, quality, high-end quarterback. I get it. He doesn't make mistakes. You have more chances to win with him. But when you're playing against the Rams and you're playing against the Saints, you got to go out there and you got to let it fly. You can't hold back. That's one of the reasons why the Kansas City Chiefs went out and drafted Patrick Mahomes. For me right now, the way Mitchell Trubisky's running the Bears offense, the athleticism that he's showing that Alex Smith has as well, I would take the younger quarterback because I know what I'm going to get with Alex, and I don't think that's going to get me past the Rams and the Saints.
Yeah, 10 years younger, Boom, when you think about that. And look, Adam, you mentioned an offensive genius in Sean McVay. I think when you look at Matt Nagy, he's not that far behind. I think that's really the benefit that Mitchell Trubisky has. Both quarterbacks are 6-3. Both have their teams atop their divisions. But I just really think Trubisky's a guy that's getting better each week. They're averaging almost 30 points a game offensively. He's coming off of a career high where he threw for 355 yards and 3 touchdowns. He's got 19 passing touchdowns on the season, and he makes plays each week with his legs outside the pocket. When you think about Alex Smith, how about this number? 178. In 3 of their last 4 games, he's thrown for exactly 178 yards. Boomer wasn't lying when he said he may be the most conservative quarterback in all of football.
Yes, Rich, we've been saying that for years about Alex Smith. And I think when you look at Mitchell Trubisky, you got to realize also, since 1950, he's the first Bears quarterback to have three games in the same season of over 300 yards passing and three touchdowns. So, and we still got the six games left in the regular season, and he's going to do a lot more. We know that down the stretch because he's just getting better and better as he goes. You mentioned the 19 touchdowns compared to 10 touchdowns for Alex Smith. Sure, the interceptions are low for Alex Smith, but they're not. They're also a very good ratio for Mitch Trubisky. He's protecting the football. He does bring that energy, that youthfulness, that mobility to play as well. I think you have to start with Mitchell Trubisky. That's no knock on Alex Smith because we know what he's capable of. But Mitchell Trubisky, I think, is one of the top quarterbacks moving toward the future.
You know, I agree with you guys about your comments about Mitchell Trubisky. I think the fact that that's why the match with Matt Nagy when he came in as head coach, I thought that match was such a good match. The offense that he was bringing from Kansas City, Andy Reid's system coming in, putting Mitchell Trubisky in position to have success. Some of the same things that he did at North Carolina when he was the quarterback there. I think that's carried over to this season. But for me, it's got to be Alex Smith in terms of trying to pick between these two, just because I know that consistency is going to be there. The way Alex Smith performs in every system that he's been on every team that he's been in. I think that when you're moving forward, the risk factor, I know the athleticism you're talking about. I think if you ask a couple years down the road, but if you're talking for one season, you know that consistency is there with Alex Smith. So for me, it's that you can't go wrong with either one, first off. But for me, if you're making me pick one this season, I'm going with Alex Smith.
All right, Trent, the dissenting voice. I like it. Meanwhile, it's Philip Rivers, the hottest quarterback in the NFL. He is Tom Brady, finally starting to show his age. Keep it locked where it is. NFL Monday QB, delivered by FedEx.
This is our workshop. This is our North Star. This is our Wonderland. And this is our season of performance. Hurry into the Acura Season of Performance event going on now. This holiday, visit your local Acura dealer for attractive offers on the MDX. Hurry, this event won't last.
Checking your fantasy league?
Nah, just my 401k statement.
Nice. Where'd you find the money for that?
I've just been saving a little every month.
I can't seem to save anything.
Well, what about all this? What about the money you're spending?
What money? It's gone before I can get my hands on it.
I got a pizza for a Todd.
Hey, can somebody spot me?
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind.
It's 547.
Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org.
A little less conversation, a little more action. All this aggravation ain't satisfaction in me. A little more bite, a little less bark. A little less fight, a little more spark. Set your mouth and open up your heart. And baby, satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby. Don't procrastinate, don't articulate. Girl, it's getting late, you just sit and wait around. A little less conversation, a little more action.
What is the future?
Future's golf.
Literally. I just booked a 10:30 tee time and invited all you folks via golf book to come golf with me. First three to confirm are in. Who's in? Jonesy's in. Oh, Sarah's in. Woo! It's getting physical, folks. And little Ricky's in. For the rest of you, I don't know. The future's like just not golf. It's the saddest possible thing I can imagine. That's a friend talk.
Hey, Gabby, how you doing? How's the play date and sleepover?
Dad, it was great.
Awesome. Okay, I'm on my way.
Hey, guys, what are you doing?
We're going swimming!
We're going biking!
Yeah!
I'll see you in a little bit, guys. I love you.
Hi, babe, how was school today?
Hi, Dad, it was great.
Okay, honey, I'll be home soon. Remember, you're never too far away from your kids to be a dad. Reach out and take a second to check in, because sometimes the smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
Keep up with your favorite team on the go with the NFL app. Get all your updates, scores, and live games during the season. Go to NFL.com/mobile. There are two words that are music to any quarterback's ears: win and streak. Entering week 10, Philip Rivers had been listening to the sweet sound of a win streak to the tune of 5 games. While Tom Brady's sweet sound of a win streak was a bit louder, he was rocking out to the words win streak for 6 games. Could that sweet sound continue for Rivers and Brady on Sunday, or did the music finally stop?
Those words have got to be music to many teams' ears, except if you know, the Raiders. The Chargers keep rolling while Tom Brady and Derek Carr tumble. Whether a team is on a winning streak or losing streak, or streak has ended, rumors tend to surface. Let's get into some potential rumors with Boomer. Tom Brady is looking like a 41-year-old. Boomer, could this rumor actually be true?
No, it's not true. As a matter of fact, I thought yesterday, even though he got beat up by Tennessee, he was moving around. He looked spry. He actually threw the ball well. I thought Tennessee covered his receivers quite well. But one thing I will say to you, Adam, is that I look 41. He looks like he's 31. It looks like he could still play for many, many years. And remember, they didn't have Gronkowski yesterday. And did he try to overuse and force feed Josh Gordon a little bit? I guess that could be the case. But at the end of the day, they are going to be no worse than 11-5, 12-4, win the AFC East, and most likely will host a wild card playoff game. And don't be surprised if it's against these Tennessee Titans, which I would say, hey, Deion Lewis, button it up. Don't be talking about a future opponent in the playoffs. Then you'll really find out what the Patriots are about.
Fair enough. I agree with that. All right, Boomer, let's bring in Trent Green. What's your take on that rumor about Tom Brady?
You know, I agree with Boomer. I think there's probably 25 to 30 quarterbacks in the league right now that would love to be playing like that 41-year-old quarterback, because Tom Brady is having an outstanding season. When you look at his numbers, I know he's struggled some in the last couple weeks, but he has 2 games this season where he's completed under 54% of his passes. Both those games are against former New England Patriots. Matt Patricia, the defensive coordinator, now in Detroit, they held him to 54% completion. And Vrabel last week, or this past week against Tennessee, held him to 52% completion. So the fact that those two guys are dialed in, if I'm an opposing team, I go watch that tape and see what those two defenses did to make him so ineffective.
You know what it is? The fruit juices and the sleepwear that he wears at night. It keeps him young and keeps him vibrant.
Yeah, I could relate as a 41-year-old. Yes, I mean, yes. He doesn't have my looks, but he's doing okay.
You don't have his height.
That's true. Rumor number two. Teams would rather face Patty Mahomes than Philip Rivers in the playoffs. Boomer, is this just a rumor or could there be truth?
There may be some sliver of truth. I'm not sure where Trent's going to go with this one, but I'm going to say that's a rumor. I would not want to face Patrick Mahomes, especially with the way that he's playing and with all the weapons at his expense. When you take a look at Tyreek Hill and you take a look at Kareem Hunt, you realize he has two of the biggest pay-play players in all of the NFL. And I know Sammy Watkins didn't play this week. Maybe that's one of the reasons why they were held to 26 points by the Cardinals. But at the end of the day, he's doing something that Andy Reid has never seen. He is getting explosive plays each and every week, and I would say that is a rumor, not truth.
I agree with Boomer. I think it's a rumor. I think when you look at the weapons that he has around him, and the one that Boomer didn't bring up was Travis Kelce, the tight end. When Hunter Henry got hurt in the preseason, they don't have him in terms of a weapon. Travis Kelce leads the NFL from a tight end standpoint in receiving yards. Patrick Mahomes also gives a mobility issue for defenses. Philip Rivers has that outstanding quick release that he's had throughout his career, but Mahomes' ability to move around in the pocket and extend plays gives him a slight advantage because he's playing at another level right now.
I like this guy. He knows what he's talking about.
Trent Green, yes. He's okay. All right, rumor number three, a healthy Marcus Mariota, who's been on fire the last couple of weeks, best quarterback in the AFC South. Luck, Watson, Bortles. Boomer, is a healthy Mariota better than all those guys?
I do not think so. Let me bring my friend over here. His name is Andrew Luck. I don't know if you have not seen him play for a while, but six games in a row, 3 touchdown passes in each of those games. So as I said earlier in the show, he actually does join Tom Brady and Peyton Manning in that regard. He hasn't been sacked in 4 games, and he's playing the best football, I believe, of his career right now. If I were a young quarterback in this league, watch how this man here, number 12, wearing the blue and white, Adam, he's about your size right here, as he's a cutout guy. Here you go. He is playing about as best, as good as he's ever played. And I would just say, young guys, watch how he plays. He is not reckless anymore. He's accurate. And his mechanics right now are flawless.
Well, once again, I agree with Boomer, and this is just the big agreement segment of the show because Andrew Luck is the top quarterback in the AFC South. When you look at the numbers, he has 970 more yards passing than Mariota. He has 19 more passing touchdowns than Mariota. I know Mariota's running a different offense, and they're winning football games. They've now won three in a row. But when you consider what these two offenses, what they're being asked of, I think Andrew Luck is the top of this division. I think Deshaun Watson, with winning six games in a row, the fact that he's gotten through the rehab portion with his knee injury, is back playing at a high level as well.
I say we reverse the roles. The next time, I'll be Trent's hype man. You did a good job hyping me up there, Trent. Good job.
Well done, Trent. Yes. Excellent. Meanwhile, the Pittsburgh Steelers become the most dangerous team in the AFC. Has the rocket ship run out of fuel? We're moving the chains. Next.
A game of honor.
Army has won it.
The Army-Navy game presented by USAA, Saturday, December 8th on CBS.
A moment of joy. A source of inspiration. An act of kindness. An old friend. A new beginning. Some welcome relief. Or a cause for celebration. What's inside? Possibilities, what we deliver by delivering.
Daryl. Hey, Daryl.
Hey.
Hey, how much would you pay for something you don't want?
Nothing. Is this a test?
No. Question two. Do you like getting stuff you like for free?
Yes, this feels like a test.
It's not. It's just why Verizon lets everyone in your family get the unlimited plan they need without paying for stuff they don't. And why Verizon gets you 6 months of free Apple Music.
Did I pass?
Not a test, but yeah, you passed.
Yeah.
The music you want, the unlimited plan you need, on the network you deserve. Switch now and get $300 off our best phones.
Free two-day delivery to your door. The ability to search by snapping a picture. And everything you need to bring more joy to the world. At the Home Depot, this is how we're making it easier to deliver the magic of Christmas. This is why. Get your choice lighting reels just $18.88. At the Home Depot, more saving, more doing.
Think a utility vehicle should do more than take you places? So does Kubota. That's why our all-new Sidekick is built to do it all. Climb more. Tow more. Go more. You get more with a Sidekick, plus everything you expect from a Kubota. Cross over to more today. See your local Kubota dealer and take your Kubota Sidekick home with no money down and 0% financing for 36 months.
Talk or taking it to the hoop as I sit down with NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to discuss the current climate of the league right here on CBS Sports Network. That should be a good show. And speaking of good shows, did you see the show that Patty Mahomes, Ben Roethlisberger, and Matt Barkley, yes, Matt Barkley, put on during week 10? All right, it's time to move the chains with Rich again. First down, Rich. Can anyone slow down my guy, Patty Mahomes?
I'm not so sure, Adam. You know, the Chiefs joined the 2013 Denver Broncos as the only teams to start the season with 10 straight games of 26 or more points. I mean, they're unstoppable. I mean, they get off to fast starts. They've scored on the first possession in every game. And how about Patrick Mahomes? 31 touchdown passes already this season, breaking the record held by Len Dawson. So, you know, I just think that combined with the fact that they're getting healthier and they're playing better defensively, the Chiefs are going to be tough to beat in December.
Absolutely. Rich, second down. Are the Steelers the most dangerous team in the AFC?
Adam, didn't you just hear what I said about the Chiefs?
I did, yes.
The Chiefs beat the Steelers in Pittsburgh, week two. But let me say this about the Steelers. They've won five straight. They're at 6-2-1. Ben Roethlisberger is playing like the Ben Roethlisberger of old. He threw five touchdowns on Thursday night against the Carolina Panthers. James Conner's been a big story. Antonio Brown and the defense in Pittsburgh is playing better. So I think the Pittsburgh Steelers are going to be a team to reckon with, not only in December, but January as well.
Yeah, they are dangerous. I wouldn't say most dangerous. I agree with you on that completely. Third down, Rich. How would you describe Brock Osweiler's career?
How about financially rewarding, thanks to the Houston Texans' 2016 contract that they gave this guy? Look, Adam, the bottom line is he's a backup quarterback at best. He's not very accurate. He misses way too many throws. He overthrows a ton of targets. The pass rush affects Brock Osweiler. You'll see him drop his eyes a lot. And look, he's got a career record of around 500. And I just think, at best, he's a backup quarterback. And I think certainly Adam Gase and the folks in Miami have figured that out.
You summed it up brilliantly, Rich. Fourth down, Rich, which rookie quarterback is in a worse team situation, Josh Allen or Sam Darnold?
Well, I think Josh Allen's in a better situation, Adam, because of Sean McDermott. I think you look at Sam Darnold, he's with a coach in Todd Bowles that's kind of a dead man walking. I don't know that Todd Bowles even makes it to the end of the season. He's not done a good job as a head coach. I think the support staff around Sean McDermott is better, and I think Josh Allen will ultimately have a better career than Sam Darnold.
I think the head coach and the play caller, obviously paramount, as you said, Rich, to the success of these young quarterbacks. Going to be interesting to see who the next head coach of the Jets actually is. In recognition of the NFL's Salute to Service campaign, the Buffalo Bills thank local military veterans at the SPCA serving Erie County this past Tuesday, along with the help of some furry friends. The event helped to promote the good work that the SPCA does for the community with their Paws and Patriots program, which is designed to help members of the military as well as these animals. Great stuff from the Buffalo Bills, and happy Veterans Day.
Two American icons are joining forces for a collaboration a century in the making. Budweiser and Jim Beam introduce the Budweiser Reserve Copper Lager, a rich lager aged on Jim Beam bourbon barrel staves with hints of vanilla and caramel rye, followed by a deliciously smooth finish.
OfferUp is a new free app that shows you what people are selling nearby.
It's kind of like a game. Every day there are new surprises.
Come on, flat screen TV.
Oh, come on, dining room table.
Come on, sofa.
Yeah, yeah.
OfferUp is free to use. Find anything you want nearby.
You got the food and room for all your friends. Now it's time for game day fun. Wherever the season takes you, always bring a home field advantage. For a dealer in the RV that's right for you, visit GoRVing.com.
This is more than just a truck. To her, it's a classroom, where she'll learn lessons they don't teach in school, like hard work and patience, and where one day she'll teach her kids. Your truck is more than just a truck, and that's why it deserves more than just any oil. Shell Rotella, the engine oil that works as hard as you.
This isn't a liner. Well, to be clear, it's an invisible liner from Smile Direct Club. Our liners take teeth like these and transform them into those. They discreetly take this and turn it into that. We send your aligners directly to you, and in an average of 6 months, you could have a lifetime supply of confidence. Join more than 250,000 satisfied grinners who got a smile they love for only $80 a month at smiledirectclub.com.
4WP is more than a store.
We're truck and Jeep experts. From wheel and tire upgrades to full custom builds, 4WP has you covered. Do your rig right. Shop online or find your store at 4WP.com.
Now you can watch me destroy your bum emails and gauge my reaction when you try to break off a call about the rats. This is still the Jungle Kooks. Act accordingly.
You're watching CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports.
It's time for this week's Eye on Super Bowl 53. Super Bowl 23 found the 49ers down 3 late in the fourth. But Joe Montana would lead San Fran on a 92-yard drive for the ages.
Throws over the middle, a 5-catch by Wright, right to the 20. He's down to the 19 for a first down for the 49ers.
Back to throw, Montana. Stepped up, throws. Touchdown, 49ers! Taylor on the touchdown! And the 49ers have won the Super Bowl.
Another Super Bowl memory will be made on CBS February 3rd. Super Bowl 23 was a rough one for Boomer Esiason. Sunday was a rough day for a few quarterbacks around the NFL. Must be feeling a slight case of the Mondays. And it starts with Ryan Fitzpatrick. Fitzmagic didn't have any tricks up his sleeve against the Redskins on Sunday. Fitzpatrick and the Buccaneers put up some numbers, but unfortunately those numbers don't count where it counts the most. The scoreboard. Another quarterback suffering from a case of the Mondays, Matt Ryan. Oh, brutal loss. Matty Ice of the Falcons, ice cold against the Browns on Sunday. The Dirty Birds desperately needed a win in Cleveland to keep their playoff hopes alive. They were playing so good going in. Matt Ryan and company just couldn't get it done. Oh, Blake Bortles, case of the Mondays. How about a lifetime of the Mondays? Blake Bortles, if only anybody could have seen this coming. If only anybody. Blake Bortles. If only anybody would have said, oh, Blake Bortles not going to get it done. Ah, Steve Berline, which one of those quarterbacks is suffering from the biggest case of the old Mondays?
Well, Adam, you can make a case for Matt Ryan for sure. And that was a crippling loss to the Cleveland Browns, who, by the way, are a lot better than people think, we're finding out. But they could not afford that loss. But I think you have to go with Blake Bortles and the Jacksonville Jaguars, because this is a team that after week four, they were 3-1 on top of the division, looking down at everybody else. 5 weeks later, they're on a 5-game losing streak, 3-6. Yeah, Bortles has been playing better the last couple of weeks, but the Jacksonville Jaguars are now at the bottom of that division, looking up at everybody at 3-6. And this was an NFL elite team after 4 weeks. Now they are an absolute piece of you know what. So we got to see how they're going to pull their way out of it.
Steve, you nailed it. Boomer, especially because we showed that Super Bowl. Let's stress the positive.
You're going to have
here
a case of the Mondays too after the show.
On the flip side of the Jaguars Colts game, how amazing is Andrew Luck?
Well, how amazing is Andrew Luck? He is absolutely awesome. You know, 4 straight games now, he has not been sacked. 6 straight games in which he has thrown 3 touchdown passes in a row, joining Tom Brady and Peyton Manning.
Wow.
That's the only guys who've ever done it. Take a look at this. Every young quarterback should be playing quarterback the way that Andrew Luck is playing quarterback now under Frank Reich as head coach, my former roommate. And I have to tell you, nobody designs plays better. Nobody calls plays better. Nobody knows how to put a quarterback in a better situation than Frank does. And I'm telling you, Andrew Luck is eating it up. And take a look at this throw right there. I mean, he's thrown the ball before Eric Ebron's even ready for it. He throws a catchable ball. His release and mechanics are flawless. And his arm strength is back to where it was before he got hurt.
How about that offensive line and Quentin Nelson? They've done an amazing job.
Quentin Nelson could be the offensive rookie of the year, believe it or not. A lot of offensive linemen don't usually get that kind of accolade, but certainly he deserves it. He's like the second coming of Zach Martin when Zach Martin went to the Cowboys. I'll say this, 4 straight games without a sack. You see the space in there. Frank's doing a great job with Andrew Luck, and Andrew Luck is benefiting from it.
And on the flip side, Steve referenced Matt Ryan and that awful loss for the Atlanta Falcons. How about Baker Mayfield and the Cleveland Browns?
Take out the offensive meeting room dysfunction between Todd Haley and Hugh Jackson. And what has Freddie Kitchens done? He's stabilized this offense. The last 2 weeks, Baker Mayfield, 46 of 62, 513 yards, and 5 touchdowns and only 1 interception. So this is a setup for a screen. He does a good job looking off the defense, having the poise to sit in there, let the rush come to him, drop it off for a touchdown pass. Now here's the athleticism. Watch how he feels an unblocked rusher coming at him. He doesn't have to see it to know that it's coming there. He feels it. He gets out, runs to the right, throws the ball on the run on the money. So this is the Baker Mayfield that won the Heisman Trophy. This is the Baker Mayfield that now at least finds himself out of what I would consider the dysfunction of that offensive coordination problem that they had with Todd Haley and Hugh Jackson.
Which is why I think it's a coveted job if you're a coaching candidate because of Baker Mayfield.
Well, I'll tell you what, Greg Williams and this staff want to stay there, so this is the proving ground for them. I don't necessarily know that that will be the case, but just moving around in your living room here.
It's great. I mean, you could do a full turn all the way around and then read the prompter.
He may not be back after this, after that Super Bowl promo to start this second.
It may have been a bye week for some, but there were some storylines aplenty. Will Kirk Cousins finally win a big game, Steve Berline? Is it the end of the road for John Harbaugh in Baltimore? More Monday QB next.
Start your morning with sports. A dash of salt.
Well, all I care about is what I'm doing.
Spice.
There's nothing about the Knicks that's interesting.
Boomer and Geo on CBS Sports Network.
I can do more to lower my A1C.
Because my body can still make its own insulin.
I take Trulicity once a week to activate my body to release its own insulin, like it's supposed to. Trulicity's not insulin. It works 24/7. It comes in an easy-to-use pen, and I may even lose a little weight.
Trulicity is an injection to improve blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes when used with diet and exercise. Don't use it as the first medicine to treat diabetes or if you have type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis. Don't take Trulicity if you or your family have medullary thyroid cancer, you're allergic to Trulicity, or have multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2. Stop Trulicity and call your doctor right away if you have symptoms of a serious allergic reaction, a lump or swelling in your neck, or severe stomach pain. Serious side effects may include pancreatitis. Taking Trulicity with a sulfonylurea or insulin increases your low blood sugar risk. Common side effects include nausea, diarrhea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and decreased appetite. These can lead to dehydration, which may worsen kidney problems.
To help lower my A1C, I choose Trulicity to activate my within.
Ask your doctor about once weekly Trulicity.
It's man versus beast. And nation versus nation. The best bull riders in the world competing for Global Bull Riding's international prize, the PBR Global Cup.
The ride around the world.
The 2019 Winstar World Casino and Resort Global Cup.
February 9th and 10th, it's Team USA versus the world.
Every child deserves to succeed, and every family deserves to see it happen. That's why VSP offers individual vision plans, coverage you can buy on your own for you and your family when it's not available through an employer. VSP gives you affordable access to trusted eye doctors in your area, as well as a wide variety of eyewear at the lowest out-of-pocket costs for the best care at the best price. Visit VSPdirect.com to see better for life for less.
Thank you, VSP.
Dependability, honesty, integrity, just like in the military and at the Air Force Academy, and certainly for my family, my grandfather, those are the things I'm always getting when I'm dealing with USAA. You can always depend that you're going to be able to get someone on the phone. Those people are going to be friendly, and they're going to be able to help you with whatever you need done. You never feel like you're just a number. You always feel like an individual when you're dealing with USAA. I'm Joe Lombardi, and I'm a USAA member for life.
USAA. Get your insurance quote today.
When we moved, we didn't have anything, so we used OfferUp. It's a free app where you can find awesome things people nearby are selling. It was a great way to furnish our home and get to know our new city.
Now we have furniture and friends.
OfferUp is free to use. Find anything you want nearby.
Steve Berline, 17 seasons in the NFL, one Pro Bowl, one Super Bowl, countless records as the signal caller for the Carolina Panthers. Trent Green, 15 seasons in the NFL, two-time Pro Bowl selection, Super Bowl champ, led the AFC in passing yards. These two accomplished NFL quarterbacks have faced adversity and menacing defenses on the biggest stage. Today, their biggest challenge awaits. Weak side, strong side, one-on-one, no holds barred.
Yes, it's backed by popular demand, America. Weak side, strong side. Steve Berline versus Trent Green. It's going down for real. Now, for those who don't know the rules, first of all, what's wrong with you? I'm going to throw out a topic. Steve and Trent will give their best arguments with a minute on the clock. Whoever convinces our esteemed judge, Boomer Esiason, will get the point. Best 2 out of 3 wins first round. Is Kirk Cousins a big game quarterback? Steve Berline.
Well, to this point, absolutely no way. And I think in order to be considered a quarterback that wins big games, you have to actually win a few big games. So I challenge Trent to see if he can name a few big games that Kirk Cousins has ever won. Now, the great thing about this, down the stretch of the season, the next 4 games, Kirk Cousins plays at Chicago, at home against Green Bay, at New England, and at Seattle. Those are 4 big games. Let's see how he does the next 4 weeks.
Well, here's the thing. Kirk Cousins is a big game quarterback, and he can only control what he can control. He can't play defense. So let's go, instead of going back over all the seasons and all the big games, let's talk about the 2 biggest games this season against the Rams and against the Saints. Both of those, as you know, Steve Berline, are losses, but the Rams scored 38 points. The Saints scored 30 points. What did he do on his side of the ball? He completed 72%, 422 yards, 3 touchdowns against the Rams, and against the Saints, he completed 75%, 359 and 2 touchdowns. He can only do all he can do. He can't play defense.
And he threw a pick 6 against New Orleans.
Thank you very much, Steve Berline.
Wait, but did that come in after the clock?
That's okay with me. This is not, we're not doing the elections down in Florida. He gets it. Stevie Berline gets the point. I like his attitude. I'm a New Yorker. He's kind of a New Yorker. I like it.
For what it's worth, Trent, I would have given you the point. But the judge, the judge has spoken. I mean, it's not the election.
That's only because you agree with him, Adam. That's only because you agree with him.
Yes.
You're right. That's exactly what it is.
Nice try, though, Trent.
Round number 2.
Yes.
Which coach on the bottom is sitting on a hotter seat, John Harbaugh or Vance Joseph? Trent Green.
You know, for me, this is going to be easy. I have to go with Vance Joseph, and I like Vance Joseph. I've had opportunities to talk with him in production meetings, and I think he's a good defensive coordinator. Here's the thing. As a head coach, he's 5-11 last season. This offseason, he revamped his coaching staff, brought in new coordinators, brought in new people that he wanted in there. And right now, they've only won 3 games. They're the 13th seed in the AFC right now. He's not getting it done. Defensively, from a statistical standpoint, they're less in total yards, passing yards, and rushing defense. So all those numbers are down. John Harbaugh has been to the playoffs 6 out of 10 seasons. It's been, for me, a no decision.
Well, I've only got 20 seconds left, but I don't need much time. I agree with Trent. Vance Joseph is on the hotter seat, and here's the reason why. John Harbaugh's proven himself already. It's already been done. He's won a Super Bowl. His team loves him. Everybody loves him. And he knows as soon as his season is over, if he gets released, fired, he's got a job anywhere he wants to go of all the options that are open.
You know, the hottest seat of all is Todd Bowles, all right? I'm going to give this one to Trent because I thought his argument brought out the facts of what Vance Joseph is going through as compared to John Harbaugh, so I'll give Trent the point.
I mean, he took 40 of the 60 seconds, yes. So I would hope he would win.
Hey, right. Well, based on the first question, I learned that you could speak overtime, and it doesn't really matter. You're going to get the win. So.
Fair enough. All right, winner takes all here. Over the weekend, Larry Fitzgerald passed T.O. on the all-time receiving list. Round number 3, who would you rather have in their prime, T.O. or Larry Fitzgerald? Steve Berline.
I don't think there's any question. I think Trent and I probably agree. It's Larry Fitzgerald. This guy has been a model of durability, consistency, dependability, and he's a leader. The production's always been there. Think about this, though. Think about if he had a quarterback for the last 5 years in Arizona like he has not had, and he's still number 2 all-time in pass and receiving yards. So I think you got to go with Larry Fitzgerald. He's a guy you want on your team in your locker room. There's no doubt about it.
Well, I do agree with you, Steve. It is Larry Fitzgerald. And first off, T.O., he's a Hall of Famer. You can't argue. You got 2 Hall of Famers here, so trying to pick the win. You look at the 6 years or 7 years of their prime, they each have 6 1,000-yard seasons. I don't agree with your argument with the quarterback. He did have Kurt Warner and Carson Palmer during his career in Arizona, so he had some pretty good guys flinging him the rock. But when you talk about his character off the field, he's been with one team compared to multiple teams for T.O. I just think you have to go with Fitz.
Man, you guys have gotten soft. Here's what I would have said. Terrell Owens is a quarterback's nightmare. Just ask Donovan McNabb. What a pain in the neck. Oh, my quarterback. And it's all about Tony Romo and everything else. It's Larry Fitzgerald, hands down. That's why Larry Fitzgerald's been on one team and one team only. I'm going to split it. They tied.
Whoa.
I can't, the argument was the same. But if one of them just would have said that Terrell Owens was a quarterback's nightmare, then that guy would have won the argument.
I have to tell you, this is year 7 of Monday QB.
Yes.
We've been doing weak side, strong side for 7 years. It's the year of the tie in the NFL. The first ever tie in the history of weak side, strong side.
Let's go to overtime.
We can't.
Hey, Boomer brought up the fact that Donovan McNabb, you know, I didn't know you could tie.
Oh, there we go. Do you want to give Trent the win there?
All right, we'll give Trent the win.
Wait a minute.
Boomer, great stuff all day. That was unbelievable. Coming up next.
You're my TV host.
What was he thinking?
When I woke up this morning, I was feeling pretty dangerous.
Once I started looking for car insurance, it was a no-brainer. I switched to GEICO and saved hundreds. That's a win. But it's not the only reason I switched. The GEICO app makes it easy to manage my policy. I can pay my bill, add a new driver, or even file a claim. Woo! Hey now, that's a win-win. Thank you.
Switch to GEICO. It's a win-win.
Are you getting the most out of your Medicare plan? Are you sure? Many people with Medicare are eligible for plans that include extra benefits. Benefits like dental, vision, and prescription drug coverage. Fall open enrollment is now. Call to see if you're eligible. The consultation is free, and there's no obligation to enroll. In addition to hospital and medical coverage at no extra cost, you can also get coverage for prescription drugs, dental, hearing, vision, and more. In many areas, plans with benefits are available with $0 copays for many services, $0 monthly premiums, or $0 deductibles. That's hospital, medical, prescription drug, dental coverage, and more included in one plan with premiums that may be as low as $0 a month. Don't miss the deadline. Call now to take advantage of fall open enrollment.
Call 1-800-586-1060. That's 1-800-586-1060.
Technical question. Does this fella golfing? This fella right here, does he appear to be golfing to you? Is that golf?
No. That's not golfing.
Correctamundo. That's not golf. That's a bunch of malarkey. Trying to get a hold of his knucklehead buddies, seeing if they're going to make the tee time, when he should have just busted out golf book, zip, zap, zoop, bop. You book it. You confirm the foursome. None of this malarkey. You don't need it in your life. Life is hard. Mortgage, kids, gluten, etc. That's Fred talk.
NFL Monday QB on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by FedEx. Possibilities. What we deliver by delivering.
Rich Cannon, what was he thinking?
Well, Adam, for the fifth time in a row, the Raiders lost by at least 2 touchdowns. And to make matters worse, Derek Carr is throwing the ball into the dirt on 4th and 5. Derek Carr, come on, brother. You're better than this. What are you thinking? How about Pete Carroll? He decides to try an onside kick down by only 2 points with just under 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter. This is the best they can do? Pete Carroll, Sebastian Janikowski, what were you thinking? And finally, this last one's a classic. How about Tyreek Hill's touchdown celebration behind a CBS end zone camera? By the way, our cameraman has already filed a grievance against Hill for having a non-union employee operating a camera during an NFL game.
It is time right now for this week's FedEx Picks and Predictions, and it's a battle between the Seahawks and the Packers. Rich Gannon, who you got?
Adam, I realize it's a short week, but I was really impressed by Aaron Jones and the Packers' ability to run the football. I'm going to take Green Bay on the road.
You know, I like Seattle at home in this one. Two teams fighting for their playoff lives, but I think the 12th man's going to come back and make a big difference. Give me Seattle at home in a big game.
The Packers are 0-4 on the road. I'm taking Seattle at home.
Feels like an elimination game. I'm not betting against Aaron Rodgers. Packers with the victory. For my quarterbacks, I'm Adam. We'll see you next week. NFL Monday QB, delivered to you by FedEx.
From the Rivers property in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, this is Poker Night in America.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Poker Nights in America.